Yeah. So we're not really looking at scavenger because the carbon's just not going to be that great. On top of that, he's got three metal mine engineers. He's got three steel mill engineers. So yeah, we can do scavenger, but we probably shouldn't. But with this build with aluminum instead of glass, suddenly scientific and expansive become more interesting. Because you don't have to spend glass to upgrade HQ, right? You spend aluminum instead. So you can tear through upgrades crazy fast as expansive, for example. As Mikhail. You know, as long as you're not dying to debt the whole time because you're still having to pay life support and maybe not making power, you know, details, whatever. Still, though, this is who we're going to give a shot. I'm just going to check settings real quick. I could try executive if I don't. Look, we might be trying executive. All this still looks fine. I don't want to do sim AI only missions because that takes forever in between missions. I like it, but it takes forever between missions. All right, let's give this a shot. Executive, a little less starting cash, a little worse production, a little higher debt multiplier. Just make things interesting. And we'll do, I suppose, by moon set. We get one growth round, and then things start to get interesting very quickly. All right. Starting money's high, though. Starting income's high. You know, that's always fun. Getting to buy stuff. Who doesn't like buying stuff? All right. So, Dr. Nekrasov, introduction. My big breakthrough in aluminum was more than enough of an achievement for one lifetime. Yet here I am on Mars. Why? The theft and use of my holo image by the black marketeer on Mars brought me here. Okay, that's fair enough. I was wondering about that, but we've got an explanation for why this guy was used as the black market dude. All right, we're good. I stay because of the gravity. The low weight is a kindness to my body. My muscles hurt less, and ALS was less of a grip on me. Has less of a grip on me. I never wanted to expose myself to the dangers of space travel. Now that I'm here, all is different. Okay. So he's happy being here now that he's here, even though he's not happy with how he got here. That's fair. That's fair. I understand. It's all good. So we only got two options this time. I imagine because we only have five opponents and then us. So that makes sense, only having two options. That way we still have plenty of people available for each mission. So let's see what we got available. We've got a residential colony. Adjacency bonuses doubled for special buildings. Once again, not all that interesting unless we really pick up a special building. And the mission reward is a network virus. Colony size can get a bit bigger, though. There are upsides to this. It's also got claims available. Underground nukes, though, which are always a bit of a worry, even with extra claims available. So let's take a look at the other one. Over here we got an automated colony, so garage modules are present instead of habitat modules, which consume power instead of life support, so that could be interesting, but only if we actually had power available here. And then on top of the power needs of the garages, the automated work modules also consume more power. So lots of power consumption going on here. So the issue is, if there isn't any geothermal energy, we're kind of in a lot of trouble. If there is, then suddenly we're in a position where we have really strong geothermal plants, right? We have three geothermal plant engineers. We can make a lot of power. So I'm kind of tempted to give this a shot anyway, because frankly, even if we lose, well, it's only week one and we can just start over. Who cares? We'll give it a shot. We can grab an extra geothermal plant engineer, because that's exactly what you want to go with. You're already extra geothermal plant engineers, obviously. Unfortunately, we don't have. See, we're in this situation where we just don't have an option when it comes to getting an extra source of power, right? We can't because it's not here. It's not available. You'll see that. It's just like all we've got is the geothermal plant engineer. So what I'm actually tempted to do is just hire a patent lab scientist. Because if we hire a patent lab scientist, then what this guy is going to do is he is going to let us go ahead and pick up cold fusion if we need to in any mission. And so we can kind of pseudo have access to power that way. It's not going to be great, but I can potentially hire him just to secure that, and then maybe contract a couple of other things to try and hang on for this particular mission. Pleasure Dome's not going to be interesting this mission because we're against two robots, and frankly, I'd be really surprised if the Pleasure Dome got a benefit off the seemingly robot colonies that we're going to be dealing with. So maybe this is all I hire this time around. I'm not sure what else would be good to pick up. Unfortunately, I don't know. Let's see, this is a Russian colony, so there are no warehouse modules, which makes things even more difficult. But that's kind of okay for us. And the reason that's okay for us is because we can't make glass anyway, so we don't want warehouse modules flying up everywhere, because warehouse modules consume steel to build and then consume glass once they're constructed. So that's going to be raising glass prices. We don't want to have to ever make glass because we have access to transparent aluminum, right? So now we just have choices to make. I'm tempted to grab the water pump, and I'm tempted to grab the chemicals. The EMP is also tempting. I'm kind of tempted to get the EMP permanently, actually. If I do that, then I can only get one other thing. And I really do want the chem refineries, just to give us something good to make. Problem is, I want the chem refineries, the elemental quarries, and the water pump. So I think we're just going to grab that. We're going to contract all those. We're going to call it good. Alright. Joji went and picked up an EMP. It's kind of unfortunate. Hopefully he throws that ready instead. Let's give it a shot, shall we? There we go. Okay. Campaign, first interval. One rotation of Mars, one sunlight cycle takes 40 minutes longer than a day on Earth. This works out fine for digital clocks. Face clocks are for decoration on Mars, like sundials on Earth. I keep a face clock in my office, synchronized to Berlin time. All right then. My company headquarters are there. Sometimes they require my attention. After twice being awoken in the middle of the Martian night, Berlin now has a timepiece with the Martian time on it. International business concerns operate across time lags, but time difference between cities remains constant. Mars and Earth rotate in and out of one another's daylight hours, and this disrupts things more than imagined. Understandable. Understandable, right? Okay, well, let's just give this a shot, start poking around, shall we? Pray that there are geothermal vents here. Well, we found some aluminum. There are geothermal vents. That's super important. So there's water up there as well. See if we can find anything good right here near this vent. Kind of. Okay, there's good iron there. So I'm kind of tempted just to drop here. Just to get on the ground. And get started. We found silicon. There's carbon not far away either. The map's pretty small, all told. So shipping hopefully won't be too much of a concern. So we're just going to drop right here and run with it. It's not necessarily the best location, but it's a functional one, and it lets us go ahead and get started, which is important. So, that said, let's go ahead and start buying some stuff up. Now, unfortunately, I'm not getting a glass benefit because I went robotic, but I think it's probably going to be worth it anyway. Just to avoid life support being too difficult. Well, it's not life support. Well, life support's still potentially going to be difficult. I would have to make all my own life support, and I'm not good at that. So I think robotic is still the correct option. Let's just go ahead and get the steel started. Get the steel flowing. Alright, no big surprises on where those landed. All we want to do is get upgraded so we can take this aluminum. We want to take this aluminum because it's the one these two are going to want in particular. Maybe make them go over here instead to these two by taking this close one for ourselves. I don't think aluminum is going to be too much of a concern. There's less consumption of it by the colony garage module than by a habitat usually would. And of course, we all use less aluminum here than other colonies do. Even I don't use that much aluminum just because I'm not going to be using that much glass. And so I don't have to replace my glass with aluminum because I just don't have any. All right, he's actually going to choose that one. No big surprise. But we just want to take the ones that are close to everybody else, right? just to make them have to ship a little bit further than maybe they would like to. Let's see. I never really looked at Black Market. It's not all that interesting this time, if I'm being honest. Circuit Overload, Mutiny, those are important. But other than that, we're not looking at too much. I should go ahead and get my electronics secured. That's going to be important, just because there are machine shops over here. And of course, these two robots will also be driving up the price on electronics the whole time. So going ahead and getting those bought up at the first opportunity is going to be important here. All right, I'm going to start selling down some steel. All right, get upgraded, grab this geotherm. I can start looking at a patent lab potentially, partially because I'm really going to be biased toward superconductor if I can pick it up. Iron's continuing to go up in price. I'm kind of tempted to just let that happen. Steel's... well, now iron's starting to drop. Steel's dropping like crazy right now. That's kind of fine, though. I just need a lot of steel. I'm not entirely sure what to do with all this. I guess we'll grab a goon. That would make a fair amount of sense right now. And now we wait patiently, or otherwise. Either way, it kind of works. Doesn't make much of a difference. Sell down some aluminum for the time being. Just trying to push to these geotherms as fast as I can get them up, since power's looking pretty frustrating. Circuit overloads might end up being quite crucial against Rennie here, since he already has access to superconductor. Now, him having access to it shouldn't cut us off from it. Do whatever we need to get that down. Yeah, we've absolutely killed steel here. Shouldn't be too much of a surprise, given that everybody's just going to start the same way when they're playing a robot. And computers in particular are not going to choose to mix things up pretty much ever. It's just the reality of the situation. The nice thing is we can use the cheap steel. As long as it doesn't get so cheap that we can't pick up these electronics, we're going to be okay. The issue is, it might get that cheap, because the electronics are expensive. So we're really going to be relying quite heavily on this power to see us through. And I think I am going to goon squad this guy. Alright, we got our superconductor. Now we're paying down debt quite nicely, so hopefully all of this will work out just fine. I'm actually going to shut all of this down for the moment. And now we wait. Patiently, preferably. We're paying down debt nicely. Hopefully this won't take too long. Rennie's wind turbine is at least very weak, so it's not going to get too much done. You can see our geotherm is 7 times as powerful as that wind turbine is. And so now you can see we're really about to start pulling in the cash. And this is what we were working toward. This is what we were looking for. It took a while to get this set up, but it was going to take the computers a long time to get to anything valuable too. So hopefully this is going to be all right. And we got to our upgrade, which is nice. I'm still not going to turn the steel mills back on because, frankly, power's too expensive for that. Why would I bother? Electronics factories aren't going to be great, but they will be functional. Somebody is trying to break our stuff. That is just rude. We'll go ahead and regoon that. We've got plenty of cash for this now. So I really would like to be able to make electronics. I don't know how much of an option that is. Colony modules are also going to be super tempting this time around. And chemicals will be good, hopefully. Now, of course, we can use the geotherm we were handed to just, you know, redo that very quickly. I could upgrade again already. That's amusing. I'm going to grab some silicon, because silicon's looking kind of difficult this time around. We'll grab, I suppose, the carbon right here. That gives us the opportunity to mutiny. Go ahead and get a couple electronics factories down. Upgrade, more electronics. Maybe look at getting some chems down. Chems should be fine. Let's see. Carbon scrubbing is actually potentially a decent option here. Financial instruments is not going to be all that interesting. A lot of these aren't really going to be all that interesting. Maybe perpetual motion. Superconductor was the big thing, and you can already see the work that Superconductor has done this game. I think it was well and truly worth it. Thinking machines is an option. Just for those circuit overloads, I'm not going to be able to goon forever. Slant drilling would be okay. I think I'm actually going to grab thinking machines just because of the circuit overloads in particular. Alright. Nice little overload there. Should be good. I don't want to pay 12,000 for it, though. I think we're going to do it anyway. Problem is, that is just cash for me. 12,000 cash that I just paid down for that. Oh, let's get the steel back online, shall we? That's kind of important right now. So this is why we went for thinking machines, is so we don't have to just defend this forever. I am just going to start buying into the colony as fast as I can now. Everybody's trying to make steel. That makes sense. We should probably make some more steel ourselves. Alright. Well, things seem to be going alright for us now. Gonna need to get some of these garage modules up, because it's important to have those garage modules available for, so that the colony becomes staffed, right? Because we can see that, yeah, the offices are great because they increase power consumption, and we're really trying to push power hard right now. But the problem is we need to buy the garage modules so that we have robots to staff our offices, obviously. So that EMP hurts. Nothing we could do about that. We can't get an EMP ourselves even, of course, because that one came from outside. But thankfully, once again, thinking machines, unfortunately, we picked up a little too late for it to affect that EMP, right? But in the future, it was just a little too late. In the future, though, when those circuit overloads land, it's not going to be a problem. This time, we're just a bit out of luck. Let's go ahead and turn these guys off. They're not going to be useful at this point. Question is any of the rest of this going to be any good? Maybe perpetual motion. Maybe that's going to be worthwhile. It's not necessarily going to be great, but I think it'll be okay. Let's grab a garage. Mutiny on the geotherm. Take that back. Thank you very much. And I'm just going to grab another mutiny. That way I've got it preloaded for when the next mutiny lands, because I'm not necessarily going to get the reflect that time. Carbon scrubbing might actually be okay, too. My other option, though, is to just go ahead and use this mutiny here and make sure I've got plenty of carbon secured for a long time. I think that's going to be all right. I really want to push the offices instead of the machine shops. The machine shops are okay, but they consume electronics, and I'm just not that great at making electronics, is the reality of the situation. I'm just not very good at it. Let me get that circuit overload down. We don't need any of this power generation nonsense. Well, chems are just getting weaker and weaker by the moment, and now they're basically useless at this point, which is a bit unfortunate, but that's okay. Ours have turned themselves off, I believe. Yeah, they're off for the time being. That's fine. Circuit overload. Keep pushing those offices. It's really what we're trying to do right now. Yeah, I'm not going to grab carbon scrubbing for the time being. Chems are obviously pretty cheap, so I could get basically whatever, but this is the weird thing about having three robots, is prices generally just don't go very high, right? That's the reality of the situation. Prices aren't going to get very high. And that makes it kind of difficult to actually push through and get modules attached to the colony, purely because you actually need a significant amount of cash per module in addition to the resources, right? So the higher the prices are, the easier it is to go ahead and pick up those modules. Shortage on everything except power. That's just great for us. All right. Well, let's go ahead and stop auto-selling power for the time being. The black market is open for business. Just see if we can hold on. I'm going to go ahead and hit this again. Okay, well, we've actually got that goon squatted, so we know that for sure now. That's nice to know. What am I interested in from here? Not much, if I'm being honest. Just not much. I can grab a core sample, drop it under these chems, see what's down there, see if it's of any use whatsoever. I never grabbed water, which might be have been a mistake, because I am so limited on claims. If I could grab a core sample and see if there's anything around here. Most of this is going to be iron, unfortunately, but I can try that one. Carbon. Not really what I was after. Not terrible. Not terrible, if I'm being honest. We could